Amen. Let's pray as we go into the Word of God. Bangamba basoga babulizo lunaku lulamba.
The basoga breathe for a whole day.
Amen.
Amina.
Amina, are you ready? Let's pray for the word before we hear the word. Gamba ayi Yesu.
Damu
na amanyi gamba ayi Yesu.
Say, oh Jesus.
Kwebaza olw'ekigambo kyo.
I thank you for your word.
Kubanga kiramu.
For it is alive.
Chikozi.
It is active.
Chisala.
It cuts.
Okusinga ekitala.
Sharper than
ekyobojo bubiri.
A double-edged sword.
Ekigambo kyo.
Your word.
Nyonde yasayasa.
Is a hammer that breaks.
Ekigambo kyo.
Your word.
Gwe muliro ogwokya.
Is the fire that burns.
Nsaba nga nkiwulira.
I pray that as I hear it.
Kyokye mu nze.
It will burn within me.
Ebirina okwokyebwa.
That whatever is supposed to be. Kyaseyase. Let it break.
Buli ekirina okwasayasibwa.
Whatever is supposed to be broken.
Leka okukkiriza kwange.
Let my faith.
Kuziba bujja.
Be made new.
Ozze bujja essuubi lyange.
That you restore my hope.
Olw'ekigambo kyo.
By your word.
Owonye omubiri gwange.
That you heal my body.
Olw'ekigambo kyo.
By your word.
Nkwebaza.
I thank you.
Kubanga ekigambo kyo.
For your word.
Kikomyawo emmeeme yange.
Restores my soul.
Yogera gyendi.
Speak unto me.
Omuddu waawulira.
Your servant is hearing.
Mu linnya lya Yesu.
In the name of Jesus.
Buli muntu n'agamba nti amiina.
Everybody say amen.
Amen. Kamba sabe mutuleko.
I request us to get seated.
Nisanyuse nnyo bala ab'oluganda.
So happy to see you, brethren.
Nze ne family yange twakomawo mu ggwanga.
My family and I came back in this nation.
Naye lwakuba bwe twatuukira mu kufiirwa.
But when we came, there was death in our midst.
Mukyala wange ne mukyala bu Kenya baafiirwa muto waabwe.
My wife.
Mukodomi wange bamuyitanga David Yogutu.
My wife and Mrs. Bukenya. My shoes and the sad news of the passing of my young brother.
Nga yali azze yeeka.
He had gone back to the Lord.
Era ensonga lwaki temubadde temutulaba bukyatukomawo.
That is why we are not here ever since we came back.
Njagala okwebaza abooluganda.
I want to thank the brethren.
Ekkanisa eno yakola kinene nnyo famire zino zombi bwe zaafiirwa.
This church did a lot when these two families lost their loved ones.
Waliwo abajja ne batuziikirako e Busia ate ne Kisagala e Masulita.
Some came for burial both in Busia and Kisagala.
Abantu babadde batukubira amasimu.
People have been calling us.
Abantu baatuwa sente bananga okufiirwa ko tekumanya naye Mukama yatuwa obugabizi okuyita mu booluganda n'ekkanisa eno.
People gave us money and God provided through the brethren and this church.
Amina. Abatakubangalo bali kubalulala. Okay. Twebaza Mukama.
We thank God.
Olw'obulamu bwatuwa abooluganda.
For the life that he gives us, brethren.
At least abooluganda, family members abo bonna, naddala brother wange, twamanya emyaka 7 nti yalwala.
At least those two brethren, most especially my brother, we knew 7 years ago.
Abadde alwana ne cancer nga tumusabira ekiseera kyonna.
He'd been battling with cancer and we've been praying for him all along.
Naye mukyala we yatugambye nti bwe yamanya nti alina cancer n'asaba Mukama amuwe emyaka 2.
But the wife told us that when he knew he had cancer, he begged the Lord to give him 2 years.
Naye ne tusaba.
But we prayed.
Cancer, Mukama namwongera emyaka 7.
And the Lord gave him 7 years.
Nebaza Mukama nti yajjangawano lumu n'asaba.
I thank God that he used to come here and pray with us sometimes.
Era mukyala we abasinga bamumanyiwa.
And many people here know the wife to my brother.
Twebaza Mukama nti Mukama yamumuzza.
But we thank God that he took him home.
Ate n'atuwa okumuziika mu kitiibwa.
And he gave him a glorious send-off.
Amina. Twabadde nabaddawo nga bwomanyi ebyokufiirwa nga weemulugunya nga agamba mukama naye yandiwanga dde n'omwongerayo emirala asatu n'okola bino.
In the midst of all this, I was complaining before the Lord and saying, but at least he would have gone for more 30 years. Because I lost at my wife's and again on my side at the same time. You know, as humans, when you lose someone, you grumble within you. But I had the voice of the Lord telling me, didn't I tell you that this year is the year of harvest? I have not complained ever again. I want you to know, brethren, that even death is harvest unto heaven. It is lost here on earth, but the heaven is harvesting. We thank God that has kept us alive. We had a good journey in America. The Lord blessed us. All the time we've spent there, we've seen the goodness of the Lord. He has done many great things.
Bible yeganti okutambula kulaba okudda kunyumya. Eh? Yaba Bible yabaganda. Okay. Alengenda babikuza. Alengenda babikuza mu kitabo kya Eliya.
I was about to tell you to open the book of Elijah.
Tusoma olunyolo luganti okutambula kulaba okudda kunyumya.
That verse that says as you move you see a lot of things.
Amina kati abana tutukira embozi yo tuyina.
So those who come to us, we have a lot to tell.
Amina.
Amen.
Mwebale kukuma ganabo Luganda.
Thank you for keeping each other, brethren.
Mwebaza katondolo abasumba.
Thank God for the pastoral team.
Babu Kenya.
The Bukenyas.
Ba Edward Taka.
The Edward Takas.
Ba Mage.
The Mages.
Ba Wanaswa.
The Wanaswas.
Ba Kadoa.
The Kadoas.
N'abaweereza mwenna administrator waffe opio abeera oba yeebaka abeera akola nnyo.
And all ministers, our administrator Opio, he's always working here.
Kansubire nti byakola mbiraba abooluganda omusajja oyo akola nnyo naye byakola birabika.
See what he's doing.
Amiina twebaza Mukama n'olw'abaweereza bonna.
For all ministers.
Abantu babadde batubuuza gye tutambulira mwe mukikola mutya okuva mu church ne mugirekawo.
People wherever we go they used to ask us how is it that you move away from your church for long periods of time.
Nga tubagamba nti kubanga si ffe naffe tuli kitundu mu kanisa.
And we tell them just because you are also part of a church.
Ekanisa yonna teyina kuvaamu muntu neggalawo.
It's not that if someone leaves the church it should close.
Any church, if someone moves the church should go on.
And
so that's who we are in Kawempe Worship Center.
And
I'm telling you, we have some amazing leaders. I can take this, listen, I can take this very set of leaders and we can walk downtown Los Angeles and we'll build a great church. I can take this very team here and take them anywhere in the world and we'll build a great church. That's how blessed this church is. Amen. Some of you complain about small things, but you need to look at the bigger picture. I've been watching these services. And I'm watching other services. And I'm like, wow, we are a step ahead of many other people. The worship here, it doesn't matter where you go in the world, the worship here is a class apart. And I want you to know we have never gone to another church to snatch their instrumentalists. Everything you see here is homegrown. Possible. I preached in two churches.
nabulirako mu kanisa nga biri.
And after the preaching, the pastors privately come to me and say, "Hey, we checked you out." You know what they call background check?
It's
people go on the internet and they put in your name.
And they,
Google will bring every social media, everything you have ever done on the internet.
Google social media internet.
Two pastors told me, "We watched you preaching." And that's why they said you need to preach for us. I'm just telling you, whatever we do here is not just for this local area. We have people watching online and they say we bless them every time our services go online.
Amen. I belong to this house.
I'm a living stone. In this house I'm growing. And what's our vision statement? To be a Christ like a Christian. In a community. To be a Christ like a Christian. In my community. You know what that means? It's not that you behave just well, because that's where most people stop and say, "I need to behave so people can see Jesus." But you need to understand that also means you influence the culture of your neighborhood. The people where you live should know. By looking at what you do, the development you put in place, you should influence. Where we live in Chiriagonja, I've been told the prices of land has gone up. And everyone is pointing at us and saying, "Since you came, you've changed the prices." That's what Jesus does. You heal the sick, but you upgrade the community. And so when I look at you as Kawempe Worship Center.
Kawempe Worship Center.
Me, I don't call you believers. You can call yourself a believer. Me, every individual in this congregation, I look at you as a leader, an influencer, a catalyst, someone that changes whatever they touch. I don't care whether you didn't eat last night. And I don't care how many debts or loans you have. Me, I'm standing here and I'm looking right at you. What I see is a champion of life. And that's how I'm going to preach to you. That's how I'm going to greet you. That's who I'm going to call you. If you want to be a loser, a failure, is only 11:45. Most churches are just starting. You can walk through that door. Go find yourself a failure church. But here in the worship center, you will win by force. Now atagambia amina kanchikudile, you will win by force.
Ngambio jakuangula lwampaka.
Your marriage will stand.
Obufumbo bwobuja kuyimirira.
Your children will serve the Lord.
Abana banaweresa mukama.
Poverty will live by fire, by
wafu.
Whatever it takes.
Wa muliro lwa chichona.
And don't even think about that we stood here and told you we lost a brother, we lost brothers. You are going to live and see the goodness of the Lord. Look at
me and the preacher today. I still have my wise acres. Wherever
I
go, I came back and I said no. Where we've been,
abantu bafe baba singa.
Our people are better.
Kati naze n'ebitubulako byengendo okubanga nzikatiriza
okutandika leero. Now I have a few things missing in our midst. Those are the things I'm going to emphasize.
I've been thinking about you.
Mbadde nkirowoozaako.
And comparing you with the other people.
Mbadde nkulowoozaako nga nkugeraageranya ne bali.
I'm convinced.
Era nkakasibwa.
No one is a failure in this congregation.
Teri kiremwa mu kibiina kino.
Ekyo kyonna kumyewo nga kinyingidde mu mutwe ne ngamba yi.
I came back with that in my head.
And I
said, we just have to panel beat our people just a little bit. I'm
conscious them.
But the people in Kawempe can change the world.
And that's how you are going to hear our messages and our preaching and our worship and our testimonies. They are going to be in that line of empowering you to become the person that God intended for you to be.
Obubaka bwafe okubuulira okusinza na buli kimu kye tukola kigenda kuba kiruubiriddwa okubanga tukusobozesa okubanga ofuuka ekyo Katonda kyakuyitidde.
I told you the morning service, you know what they call in the weapons of the youth, the Americans have made that bomb, they call a cluster bomb.
Aba America bayina bomu eberamu obubomu obulala obutini.
It is one in many. They denote the bomb in one place. But
it
goes on destroying everything. Because inside, they put like several other bombs just in one. That's who you are. You come to rent a place. The witch doctor should know. You come to rent a place. The shop owner should know. Everyone should know that you have come to reside there. And it should be the conversation of the season.
Oshegera. Amina. The things of talking about you, they have to talk about you.
Why?
That's how you know that you are becoming influential. Don't think they will only talk good about you. Just make sure that your name does not leave their lips. I was reminding Mrs. Kasoza. We were in Masulita and we had a church down in the valley. That even when we had the drum sets and the machines on, nobody would hear us. Until a few Catholics got born again.
Father Naji Fulensonga.
And the father began talking about that. Wherever he preached. In their holy masses, he would say, don't go to the Kasozi, they are thieves. The born agains are thieves. Then the Catholics would ask, where is Kasozi? Then they would come. As if that was not enough. He is the head of the Catholics in Uganda. The cardinal came to our place. He went village by village, calling for a holy mass and telling people that when you go to the hospital, when you get healed, do you stay there? And people would ask, where is that hospital? The hospital is in the Balokoli. Because we would cast out devils and pray for people. In the meantime, the Sava Christu had got born again.
Archbishop. The leader of the late. Yabera kulia bakuli wabera wo faza muto adaka wabera abakulisa mumita omukubiza abakulistayo.
The bishop.
Abakatu chawamita Sava Christo.
The archbishop.
Neda sebo. Abakatu chimuja kunyamba. Unumumuise musomero liye wamu. Oyo yakulira bisomesa byonna ye dobozi lya abakristo eri bafaza ne
the head of all convents is the voice of all Catholics.
lumolu nakolu najja nabantu 15.
In one day he got born again and he came with 150 people.
Yajja ku Sunday kumacha netu ekanisa afa nejula mu lunakolu.
He came one Sunday morning and our church was filled within one day.
Kati abo Luganda.
Now, brethren, don't forbid those people that talk about you good or bad,
sure,
let them be.
Just make sure your name never leave their lips.
And they wake up saying, Pastor Kasozi. As they go on the
border,
Pastor Kasozi, we hate him. Those that hear, we hate him, they'll ask, who is he? We want to see him.
Yes,
that's how they did to Jesus. And they sent people to arrest him. They waited for him to end the service so that they would arrest him. When they went back, they asked him, where is he? They said, we've never seen a man that speaks such good words as him. I pray for you in the name of Jesus. Let me go back to what brought me here. The things that I saw in the church of
Uganda.
Before the Lord takes us to go and change the Americans because we're going, there are not so many. But let me read you a scripture. Genesis 12.
In Genesis chapter 12, starting from verse. We'll read up to verse 3. The Bible says, Bible, and now the Lord had said to
Abraham,
get out of your country, from your family,
and
from your father's house, to a land that I will show you. Verse 2 says, I'll make you a great nation. I'll bless you and make your name great, and you shall be a blessing. I'll bless those who bless you. And I'll curse those who curse you. And in you, all the families of the earth shall be blessed. Now look at me, church. I want to explain to you something. It
has
been proved by researchers. People who talk about development and success. They believe that a few pillars of success. And they say, number one, successful people are knowledgeable people. So knowledge is key. Number two, it is being said and believed that character is a pillar of success. Number three,
it
is being believed and said that environment is key and a pillar to success. Let me hear you repeat those three. Number one, Wanji? Order is key. Number one. Number two. Number three. Mwebale kuyiga luzungu.
Thank you for learning English.
Kambabuli abo Luganda.
Let me tell you, brethren.
Anywhere you go in the world, the people that know
abantu abamanyi
are powerful people.
Bantu bamanyi.
Knowledge is such a powerful tool.
Okumanya chintu chikuru nnyo ddala.
Then most people who know become puffed up with their knowledge.
Nti abantu abasinga abamanyi ate bafuuka bamalala mu kumanya kwabwe.
The Bible condemns ignorance.
Bible ekolimira obutamanya.
It totally calls it lack of vision. My people are destroyed for lack of what?
People
are destroyed for lack of what? Knowledge, because knowledge empowers the mind. Knowledge empowers the person. People who know in this nation are very powerful people.
Bamanyi nyo.
And people who don't know nothing.
Era abatalina kye bamanyi.
Are suffering people.
Be bantu ababona abona.
So we've been. So knowledge is not just the information we gather in our heads.
Okumanya siye bintu byetumanyi betukunganya mitwe jaffe.
Knowledge includes things like skills.
Naye kirimu ne bintu ngobukugu.
The ability to transfer what you know through your hands into something very practical that people need.
Obusobozi okukyusa ekintu ky'omanyi mutwe gwo mu n'okizza mikono gyo n'okiteeka ekyo abantu kye balabakera kye beetaaga.
Skill is very important.
Obukugu kikulu nnyo ddala.
Skill is part of knowledge.
Obukugu kimu ku magezi.
What you know. If you know how to use it, so people can start to seek you because of what you know. Let me also tell you something. People will not gather around you unless you have something they need. You can complain about pastors, you can complain about the church, but let me tell you something. Until you've got something that people miss when you are missing, your phone will never ring. Why? You have nothing with you that we need. Skill is very important. Skill is part of knowledge. For the last 4 years, I've been telling our worship team, if you want to join the worship team, don't just bring your vocals. Learn at least one instrument. One instrument. Let it be your skill. Let it see something. Let it be something that you can use and do. You know why? Because from South Africa to Cairo, every African can sing. It may be off key, but an African can sing. Have you heard those Zulu people in the morning? Have you had the Zulus when they wake up? They don't need a choir leader. They don't need a choir leader. If the Zulus are gathering in a place, they will just start a song. Mkosi ya makosi. And the whole village will echo with a sound that's so beautiful. But what makes you be needed in Zululand? Go and play guitar. Because I can tell you, in Uganda, out of a thousand people, only one can play guitar in Uganda.
Omu yekaya solo kusuna guitar.
No, musilise. And I can tell you, a guitar, is a global instrument.
Chivuga echiita munsi yonda.
Everywhere you go, there's not a culture that doesn't use a guitar.
Tewari wobuwangwa butali munno.
You know what? We still have we have a music school. We are just missing a few things. But we have a full-time teacher. We have everything we need. We stood here and told you there is a music school. And none of you have sent your children. Instruments are rotting up there.
They are seated.
How many know
that you can be a doctor, a surgeon, but you are a guitarist in church? Look at me very well, brethren.
You can be an
MP, but you can also play guitar as well. We have a friend who went to be with the Lord. He was called Pastor Mugerwa. He was there in Katwe. He would play the xylophone and the drums. A man came and looked at him playing the xylophone.
nange ngulira ya madinde.
I said buy for me the xylophone as
ngenda
well.
Gatwala.
I'm going to take them.
Oh, you know kujira konsomeso gakuba mu
America. You have to come with me so that you teach me how to play.
Bwato musumba mugero wekatwe yagenda muguru.
That's how Pastor Mugero who went Bwato to be with the Lord. Bwato
yaingira America ngagenze kusomesa muzungu kuba madinde.
That's how he went to America teaching a white person how to play the
musumba
xylophone.
Musumba mugero yasoma genda wala.
He wasn't that land.
Nayenga yogeze dinda tum 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 tum.
But he would play the xylophone very well. He went by the airport and those who have degrees would stamp his passport.
And pray for us. We are coming.
And then he would pass by them and they would ask him to pray for them.
Pray for us. We are also coming.
To serve it enough to jump.
Yes, you can go.
Also
a lot of people have gone, but to do what?
That's a question.
The big question is not, can you go? The big question, what can you do when you go? Ladies and gentlemen, that's how powerful knowledge is. When you know,
and
knowledge people are very powerful. We've talked about character. From the beginning of this church up to now, we will talk to you about character. Integrity. Honest. Transparency.
Purity.
Those are things we shall never stop to talk to you about. And we will not let them down. We shall not lower the standard for anything. Character and knowledge are very powerful things. But I've also watched in the church people that are so powerful in knowledge and have character, and I've seen them rot in poverty, never get to do anything. There is any one place, and you just know if you give them, if you give them
your land title, you find it with them, but they cannot do anything with it.
Basaba,
they pray hard.
Basiba,
they fast. Every week they fast for 8 days. They pray for 25 hours a day. We have such people here. And the years I've spent in the born again churches, I know those people and I can see them. But every week if they are to come to pray, you have to send them transport.
What happened to the knowledge they have about God and the things of the Bible and the character they hold so dear, but yet you don't see their lives be like a Christ-like Christian apart from greeting people and going to burials and doing the nice things in the community. Until I read my Bible and I came to these verses and I've been doing my research, and this is my conclusion. Every person that God ever used in the Bible, he will always take them out of their comfort zone and create them for them a new environment they are not used to, because it is being proved and said that comfort is a just giant destroyer. Muntu nulira oyo ayeba se mugamba azukukampulirize aliyo kaddewo. Thank you, brother. Are you listening to me?
Mumpulirize bulungi.
Sit upright and I want you to listen to me.
Tula bulungi ompulirize.
I know that's a comfortable position for you to sit in church, but let me listen to me, my brother.
Manya what to do ulira bulungi na empulirize.
Comfort is a giant killer.
Bi ebintu ebita nagwano mugwe.
Nchikudire comfort
is a
giant killer. When you get to a place where you think you have everything you need, you know what happens?
Mock. Scorn.
Despise. I want something stronger. scorn. Yes, scorn sounds like to scorn. Scorn is better. You know, scornful people. Are people who know they have everything. And when they usually look at people who are lesser than them. And they think they are in heaven. When they look to someone who is above them, they don't want to look there. So they create an environment where they are contented, where they are satisfied, no more desire, no more ambition, and they will ask you, why should I pray? That's a person that created a comfort zone. And you know, by the time they do that, every gift, anointing, and calling is dying in their comfort zone. So God, in His wisdom, I've read my Bible. This is Abraham. God is thinking about making a great nation. Not the only nation, but a great nation that's going to be an example, a model for other nations. Listen to me, people. Those of you that study theology, God did not intend Israel to be the only nation, but God intended that Israel should be a model nation. Are you listening to me? So whoever looks at Israel would desire to build a greater nation by following what they follow. Like it is always is. When God wants to do something, He will look for man. He will find a woman. And this time God is intending to build a great nation. So the Bible says, go to Abraham. And he says, go out of your country. From your mother's land. And go to a land that I will show you. And the Bible says, Abraham immediately leaves. And come to a place why we call the Middle East. The land of Palestine. And he settled there. Why? Because look at me. I want you, as I talk, I want you to start thinking about your family. You remember your years of infancy. You remember going to P2, P3, P4. You remember that environment? Mommy's boy. My mother's daughter. We who grew up with our grannies. I was the husband in that home. You remember those environments? But I also remember the toxic environment they became. When I was in P1, I could jump. I could go on the tree and jump. But when I became, when I started to understand, I was told, you can't jump, or you shall break your leg. As an infant, I knew I could do anything I wanted. But as I grew, my limitation came closer to where I was. And I was told there are things I could never do. And therefore, I remember my nicknames in school, in the village, even in home. They look at the thing that I did. And I remember respectable, honorable people in my life telling me the same thing. And I started believing what they said. I have so many, I have brothers and sisters. And I have so many mothers. That explains my environment. When I say I have so many mothers, you understand. You are all Africans. So when I say I have many mothers, by one father, you all understand. Okay, let's go on. So that's environment. Sibling rivalry. Because the mothers who send their children and tell them that that boy will never succeed. Because after the death of my sister, who was my elder sibling, I became the elder son. And anywhere in Africa, an elder son is a threat. So remember the fights. Just put me down. And I believed everything they said. And I started seeing myself that I'll never go anywhere. Thank God for salvation. I remember when I got born again. The environment was so toxic. I left. And I came and lived at the church. That's the day I found out that actually you can work with your hands and make a living. I understood that everyone who goes to school does not have to depend on their parents. So I started sending myself to school by working. You go back to a place, to that church where I grew from. I never received any transport for free. My name is against my wages. Look at me very well, brethren. I'm no longer in my father's house. I'm in an environment. If I don't work, I don't eat. I was praying. I was fasting. I also did forced fasting. Because there are so many days when I didn't have a coin to buy a single meal. And I remember my mother telling me, "You never beg if you come from this house." And we grew up with that pride. We are poor, but we never beg. Who work for the food we eat. And that thing has stuck in my mind. It is hard for me to eat free food. That's who I am. So God took me out of my environment. I was cut off from my family for about 3 years. And during those 3 years, the Lord started transforming my mind into the person that I'm still becoming today. By the time I went back to my family, I was no longer the person they knew. But they thought I was the same. They began calling me those nasty names they used to. And the Lord had already changed my mind. I was on a new level all through. I was thinking new stuff. I would see differently. I had visions and dreams that I wouldn't have gotten in that house. Sometimes, even after prayer, and fasting, and all the spiritual discipline, maybe what is lacking in your life, you need to leave that toxic environment. Look at me well, I've spoken. You can't stay there. No one encourages you. Everything, every circle you sit in. If you are not talking about poverty, you're talking about the rich who steal money. So every house you see that is painted, those are things. That when Museven goes, we are going to break those houses. In this nation, there are people who have never stolen a single coin from anyone. But they have a lot of money. They are there. But because of where you stay, you think whomsoever drives steals. You wait the day you drive, that's when you know. Some of you need to leave that place.
Those things you quarrel.
You
are just wasting your time. Just shift. Change your mind.
Leave
the levels of those people that speak about
other
people.
Get to the level where you discuss issues and purpose and vision and future. That new language. When people, you hear people say, loans, mortgages, stock markets. You need to go to that level.
You should stop the level of just quarreling
for bread. I saw these things, let me take them to Uganda, stuck
in an environment where they don't talk about you. Everything good was stolen. No.
I see Uganda on social media, Uganda and China. Uganda internet.
I see Ugandans on social media talking about poverty, fed up of Uganda. At the beginning of this year, I went to Absa Bank.
Kezia worked
on me.
Absa Bank.
In Absa Bank. And I lined up. And I saw a man with a big bag. When he went to the counter, he took off his backpack.
He brought out
bundles of dollars, hundreds of dollars, without any 50, and he lined them up there. And they were as high as that pulpit. I came, I was looking for only $500 from the bank. Only 500. This one had about $5 million. In this economy. And at the gate, there was a policeman. He was going to put them on his bank account. Ladies and gentlemen, you cannot tell me that he was a thief. He went through all the city with $5 million and brought them on the bank counter. The girl counted money until her back began hurting. And for him, he was seated on his phone. For me, I was busy changing the money. If God touches him and gives a tithe, I began saying bye.
Katikatona nakole chamagano mchifanjo siteka kwa account ye divaseka kuya. Kweka nakuba mufana nyinga ndi mulaini.
I took pictures and imagined a lot of things in that line.
Kubyo nabye nalawaza te kuli chigenda kola
neji. I imagine nothing came to fruition.
Era ne bampe bitano byange ndoze no muwale ya zimpanga mazo kubalori ya ngamba ne yesi.
They gave me my 500.
Ya ndoze yategera nti enseri mwenja ulu. Ona leso bakadde bwa dola bitano baswa je dola bitano.
This one brought $5 million. This one just took out $500,000.
Just for information, those people are with us.
Abantu abali wamu nafe.
And they are not, they don't have different blood.
Atenga tebalina musayi gwa njawulo.
They just learned.
Baiga buyizi.
Their environments.
You
can go into. And you thrive. Before you came back. We are visiting Justin Natchez in Los Angeles. And we went to this place. It is a movie studio.
To get a movie studio.
It's called Warner Brothers.
And I
went to read about their history. In
1886.
A Jewish couple. With four boys. Left the country of, I want to say, Romania.
Bava Romania.
And they went to the United States.
Ne bagenda mu America.
And the man was a shoemaker.
Omusajja yali mukozi wa ngatto.
And one of his sons, I think these things are on YouTube, you can Google them. The Warner Brothers history.
Bino ebintu biri ku YouTube osogera no binonyerezaako.
And one of their sons found a recorded movie, the first movie ever, in the first film to be made.
Nasanga film yasokera dala dala okuteekebwa ku record.
And he got the rights
n'agikwata
to show it everywhere.
So I don't know
what machine they use, but they used to have this thing that they would roll like this. And they would put the movie on the screen. And people would come and pay. That's how the movie industry in Hollywood starts. This family, the Warner Brothers. The guy started by showing a movie. Then he ended up renting halls in various cities to show different movies. He generated enough money and started paying for those movies to be made. Right now, it costs $25 for you to take a tour in their studio, the Warner Brothers studio. And one person, $25. And takes you about 8 hours to finish the tour. From here to police yokutano, why you tell what? No, the kutano. Eri police yawad.
Why is it? Why is
it? From here to why is
it? It's
their property. The Warner Brothers Studios.
Warner Brothers.
They died.
Bafa.
And their children died.
Naba bafa.
The third generation, I think they sold the company.
Abazukulundoza bebatunda company.
But you know how it started?
Neoma iwe chabao.
The father and the mother.
Tata ne mama.
Had to leave the country.
Bali bayina okuva munsi yabwe.
Because everyone there was a shoemaker. When they went to
Los Angeles,
the man became the only shoemaker. And when his son found an interest in movies, the father sold his golden watch and a radio in the house, and he gave the capital to his son.
Now, mtawaniwe capital.
In the next 25 years, they made money. They could never consume in one generation. Most of the movies you see on your television screen are made in the Warner Brothers Studios. It took a person leaving their environment to another environment.
Ibrahim.
Yeah, you know, Muzala
had to leave where he was born, Abraham. So they would leave these people. They are not bad. We don't cast
them.
But if God is to do something, there are certain places you have to leave. For you are in the village and they say, the granny down there, the reason why you go to that granny, because the granny that gives birth to mama, the brother, the sister. They tell you about the relationship. And you drive family
ono
tree. Now this is the granny. But the brother to the granny. The brother to the judge. Now the brother to the judge. Now that's when the father used to call
singer.
So you have a battle on one village. They will tell you that one is the son to
so-and-so.
The mother was not supposed to be a wife in that house. But when they left Chagwe, the judge to the judge had gone to because the other one did not get healed and got a disease. Now this one came and took over the home. This is a son to so and so.
That's where you have to,
you want to build your fighting. This belongs to my father. We have to get a portion.
They call you a goat. They call you a dog.
The neighbors are Katonda Abuluganda. Thank God, brethren.
Katonda Yanzi Jayo.
God took me out of that.
You have to leave.
Some of you, this is the gospel I'm preaching to you.
Go.
Stop debating whether you have to leave Uganda. Genda. Go. Passports are not free. Here. Even the Baganda just came.
And see. Ebaddeko ku bantu nga bamuvinga Isirayiri teyaliwo paka Ibrahimu ngaze.
Israel did not exist until the coming of Abraham.
Mumpulirize munetegereze.
Listen to me and look at me well.
Genda nga ebyalo.
Go and look through villages.
Olabe nti amayumba gasinga obunene ku byalo kwe mubeera.
I see that the biggest houses on the villages where you stay.
Abasikira ebyo ebyalo si be balina amayumba manene.
Those that inherited those villages are not the ones with the big houses.
Where the world works.
Where it you and see where kola.
Environment. I have been to villages where the smallest house belongs to the original owner of the land. And they will tell you,
he's the one that sold to the judge. The other one is the doctor. Brought a lecturer. Now the owner becomes a squatter. Why? The thing called environment is very powerful. Unless you live where you are and you get things that challenge you,
you always be what people say you are. But when you go out of your comfort zone and you go to a place where no one knows you, learn to work with your hands. You learn to think out of the box. You force yourself and stretch. No one can die out of pain. The Bible says, when God was about to use Jacob, he took him out of his father's house. For 21 years, Jacob slept outside. By the time he was done, he had 12 sons and 4 wives. But a hard worker. Before that, the Bible says Esau was a hunter.
Bible egamba Esau yali muyizi.
But Jacob was a man of the tent.
Yakobo yabelanga muwema.
And some people want to say the tent means that he was a farmer. No.
Abamu bagalagamba nti wema kitegeeza yali mulimi
nedda. He was a guy that watched movies from sunset to sunset.
Yabelanga wakakulaba sinema.
Saying inside.
Ngasula munyu abera munyu.
Omanyi bana abana balenzi nga mama wafumba nga n'omwana omulenzi atudde wano naye nga alina ekirevu.
You know these old boys, as the mother is cooking, he's there with his beer.
Mama,
that is Jacob. As the mother is testing, salt is given to the son as well to test. And the girls in Kawempe want to marry
Esau. When
Esau saw those things, he went to hunt. Then God says, I want to use Jacob, but he's also testing salt. He tells Esau, go and say, I'm going to kill him. When Jacob heard so, he ran away. When he went there, he used to wake up early morning. They
poured
on him. And they told him, this is not your mother's house. Let me tell you.
Yakobo baamugoba.
They chased away Jacob.
Oli yali kojjawe.
The other one was an uncle.
Naye bw'atuuka eri yamugamba sebo zuukuka.
But when he reached there, the uncle told him, wake up. You are going to work.
N'akola emyaka musanvu.
He worked for 7 years. He was given a wife.
Ne bamuwamu mukyamu.
They gave an
another. N'akola emyaka musanvu ne bamuwa mutuufu.
7 other years he was given the right
woman. Yagenda okumala ng'alina abaana 10.
At the end he had 10 children. And he had nothing in this
earth.
He told him, do you want to get your own? Go and work for another 7 years. As you pay yourself.
For 21 years. He was with
a family that belonged. He was at his mother's family, but they would not have pity on him.
That's how God works.
Katonda bwati wakola.
He will stretch you.
Aja kugazia, aja
muntu nulile wasajja banange munetegeze. You need to be stretched.
Oh, ino kunanulwa.
Va ku nyumba zechika.
Leave the clan houses.
Munetegeze nzenjogera va ku nyumba zechika.
Leave the clan houses.
Va we wakulira.
Leave that place where you grew up from. Leave the place where your brothers are.
Gendo pangi sebo boina kali munebo mwera mwana muwala.
Go and rent if you have a job, even if you're a girl.
Olidanga bakwanjula ne vawaka.
Where we are, you come back when you're introducing, but leave your house.
20 years,
27 years, you're coming back to
keep food for me.
At 27 years, how do you quarrel for food?
Let me tell
you.
Look
at me very well. This world has no mercy. Stop calling people every month.
God has never made you to be a beggar.
Katonda takuteka ngao kuba musabiriza.
He's going to make a nation out of you, and he cannot let his name on the ground by making you a beggar. Aika
kukola mugwanga dene yata sola kuleka linyalie kufa weritio. Ladies and gentlemen, if I get time, I'm going to prove in the Bible that everyone that the Lord used to get him from his family, his village. When God wanted to use Joseph, Joseph was taken up to Egypt. When he wanted to use Jacob, Moses was taken from Egypt to Midian. When God wanted to use Jesus,
he took him from Nazareth
to other places he knew not.
Every woman and man that God used, they created their winning environment. They created an environment of winners.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is what I brought. And I'm going to challenge you. You cannot be there asking your mother, should I chase after my passport? Please do.
Abantu bana Uganda mbalaba wali bayingira Canada bafuna obutuuze ate eggwanga lya Filikiriza omuntu okubeera n'obutuuze bwa mirundi ebiri.
I see Ugandans, they go to Canada and they get citizenship and our country allows dual citizenship.
Nze abantu bengenda okukkiriza okuleka wano.
The people I'm going to allow to leave this congregation.
Bebantu abayitibwa nga nze benayitibwa.
Are the people who are called just as I am.
Ng'oli mulevi toyina gy'olaga.
That you are Levite and you are going
nowhere. Ojja kulya wano, tujja kulya wano.
You are the one who is going to eat, we shall eat from here.
Olana ange yamanyi nti bampitira kawempe otu.
Even me who knows that I was called for Kawempe, you go there and you get taken and carried out by the cars.
You hear Pastor Taka preach
and you say, I wish they called me and they tell me don't come back. The temptations are never ending. Because I looked at the pastors there and I said, but look at this one. If I get
Taka
and I get the worship team of Kawempe and I bring them here, and we come, four people of us, within 1 year we have a building and we are also doing well. Some of you are not called. You never heard a voice telling you that you die in Kawempe and you are here wasting time. Let me end with this. This one was in Seguku. She was fat enough. Well advanced. But every day, she would come from Seguku to Owino to look for a coin. At the day she wouldn't go to Owino, they wouldn't eat. She suffered that she would even dare the rains to go to Owino. She stayed in Seguku. She was a believer in church. She was about 70 and sometimes she would fail to come to church. Someone opened her eyes and told her, this is where you are. You can sell about 200 million. 100 by 200 feet. She had a house which was
old. But we pastors used to
love her so much in
Seguku.
And we'll ask her, why didn't you come to church? And we'll tell her, please don't miss like that. She sold that place. I don't know who advised her. She went to Namayumba, Hoima Road. Bought 5 acres. At about 10 million each acre. And she built a bungalow. Which she would live in heaven, she built here. And she built poultry houses, bigger houses. And every child has their own bedroom. She has where to farm from. She even has capital. She had capital for the workers. She got a church. And she became the church elder there. In Seguku, she was a believer all her years. When she went to the other church, she became big. Environments can put you down, telling you you have no person here, you can never mount up to anything. Here in Kawempe, you cannot be here and be a failure. And that one, there's someone they sent to us on our WhatsApp platform. On the pastor's platform, please don't ask for the video. He was a believer, he used to sit behind
him.
We would ask him, where have you been? You are not in church these days. I saw him seated on a chair, surrounded by about 5 pastors. And they were anointing him. And they were declaring from today, you a pastor. A pastor of this
flock.
In this church, which we know not. And when I saw it, I sent it to him and I with 3 question marks.
He
said, Pastor, I want you to come and tell you.
And
I told you, you're not here. And I asked, were there other pastors?
He
said, now I want to put things right. What should I do? These ones have made me a pastor. Now what you tell me is what I would do. At first I was annoyed. Them, you are ahead, not the tail. Told him, are you really a pastor? He said, yes.
Why?
Said, okay. Be there.
Sumba abantu.
Pastor people. That's what I'm praying for in this church. That the least among us will be a thousand. The weakest shall be a great nation. You never sit behind in the name of Jesus.
This church is preparing you for your future. Many of you are elders. Many of you are board members on church boards. Many of you are senior pastors. The Lord is preparing you. This environment is to prepare you. But we need to do what Jacob did. The Bible says, he won. He struggled with God. He won.
Many of us have won in God here in Kawempe. We have visions, but we don't know how to win with people. Have no friends. People. And you haven't put in effort to win with people.
The anointing will be so powerful. If you can use emotional intelligence. Jacob won with God. And he won with people. You need both.
wetaga katonda.
You need both.
Wetaga byombi.
Ebyo bintu bye muliko nga mwekweka mutukaleti mutule mabega tobuza tofayo. May it stop right now in Jesus' name.
No things of hiding yourself. You come late, you sit behind. Don't bring nobody to come in.
You know too much to be a church believer. And I'm telling you people, as a pastor here, I don't believe you are meant to be here forever. A time will come when the Lord will send you. But wherever you go, you'll never be a believer again. You are a world changer, an influencer. Wherever the Lord takes you, tetugenda kukiriza muntu kuvaano naingira politics nafuka LC chairman tutandikira kubwa meya nagenda waguru mu linya lya
Yesu. We are not allowing people here to become LC ones. We start with mayorship.
Tetukiriza muntu kuvaano.
No, nobody will leave this place.
Emyaka jonno baddo okebera uyimi yakuluje emyaka jonno okebedde obuchoja ate atera ni mukanisa ndalofuka mukebezi nedda.
All years you've been an usher, ushering people, and again in other churches you become an usher. No to that.
Ekanisa yedda ko mukama jali kutwala.
Your next church where the Lord will take you.
Utekwa kuba mukadde wa church.
You have to be a church.
Utekwa kubera pastor.
You have to be a pastor.
Mwabatu da munetegerezo
gena kubera. You are seated there.
The most perfect muchala musumba the world has ever seen.
Muchala Musumba singa yensi gwe yali
erabye. The most perfect muchala musumba the world has ever seen.
Musumba singa yensi gwe yali erabye.
You are the next preacher Uganda is waiting for.
Mubulizi adako Uganda kweli.
You are the most powerful Bible teacher Uganda is waiting for.
Mubulizi wa Bible ya chasinga yo Uganda kweli ndiride.
You are a leader Uganda is waiting for.
Mukulembeze Uganda kweli ndiride.
Echo nchikulangiria ko mulingalia Yesu.
I declare that upon you in the name of Jesus.
Ndaboyimirira.
As you stand up.
You are a leader.
Oli mukulembeze.
No matter where you go.
Sinsonga wachola.
Canada will receive you.
Canada jakukiriza.
United States will receive you.
America jakukiriza.
Europe is waiting for you.
Emungereze kulindiride.
Africa is waiting
Africa
for you.
Africa kulindiride.
Anyo ya tawanika mikono nga bwensaba
mu nyanya. Raise your hands as I pray in the name of Jesus.
Tandiko kwelangiria ko nga bwogamba.
Begin declare upon yourself as you say.
I am not a pew warmer.
Nze siri mtu ati
the Lord is preparing me. My time is now. My time is coming. I will rise and I will shine. And the glory of God will rise over me. And nations will receive me. Villages will wait for me. I'm a conference speaker. I'm a motivational speaker. I'm a mentor of many. I'm a father to nations. I'm a mother to nations. I'm a conventional speaker. I am a world traveler. I am a disciple maker. Come on, declare something over your life. Anyo yo demali yogera oli musubizi. Speak. Welangirie kote oli musubuza kuteshibuga.
Declare that you are a trader in this city.
Langirie chintu ngatokwese mikono.
Declare something without hiding your hands.
Wanike mikono langirie kubula.
Raise your hands. Declare upon yourself.
Gamba ndi muteso siri mushira.
Say I'm ahead and not the tail.
Gamba ndi wagulu so siri wansi.
Above and beneath.
Ndi muwangu zino kuchira.
More than a conqueror.
Pelicha kulwanisa chiwa sapo kulwanana.
No weapon against me.
Echigendo kulaba
mukisa. That shall ever prosper.
Sigenda kufa.
I'm not gonna die.
Ndi kuba mulamu.
I'm gonna live. You see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. I come from the poor. I come from the poor. But it has no portion in me. I am blessed. Even my feet are blessed. My mouth is blessed. My children are blessed. My house is blessed. I may not be well. But the Lord is taking me somewhere. I may not have many days.
I'm going somewhere. I am my way to greatness. I am tired of my mediocre life. I'm tired of
lift up your hands.
Declare
me and my house.
We
shall serve the Lord. Me and my children. We shall fear the Lord. Raise up your hands. You're coming out of the poverty of not fearing God. Witchcraft has no passion in you.
No weapon formed against you
shall
prosper. No witchcraft is against you. Every accusation, every slander, everything that has ever been said against you, every negative word, every curse and spell that the enemy has ever pronounced over you, we dismantle, we cancel, we denounce. Nkulangiria kontoli mutotoli mutia.
Declare upon you your head, no day. You will get married.
Oja kufumbirwa.
You will get married.
Oja kufumbirwa.
You will get married.
Oja kuba na maka.
You have a family.
Oja kuva mu muziko.
You have a home. You leave that rented house. You leave that rented house.
Katonda oja kukodesa.
The Lord shall use you.
There is an anointing on you.
Come after God.
There is an anointing on you.
Come after God.
There is an anointing on you.
Come after God.
There is an anointing on you.
Come after God.
There is an anointing on you.
Come after God.
There is an anointing on you. Your head. You are anointed for such a time as this. Come on, lift up your voice.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus. Come on, just continue. Just continue. Continue. Declare, just declare that upon your life. Declare it upon your family, upon your children. Declare it, upon your household. Declare.
Genda masango langirira.
In the name of Jesus.
Mulinya lya Yesu.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Mulinya lya Yesu lya
man. Come on, go on.
Genda masalangirira.
Just go on.
Kakawa langirira bolangizi. Chirangirire.
Declare.
Chirangirire.
Greatness.
Obukulu.
Greatness.
Obukulu.
Greatness.
Obusukulemo.
Increase.
Okwayangalako. Ebyamuyika.
Abandon.
Omuyika.
Abandon.
Omuyika.
Abandon.
Omuyika.
Abandon.
Omuyika.
Yes.
Wewe.
In the name of Jesus.
Mulinya lya Yesu.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Mulinya lya Yesu lya
man. Come on, declare it.
Langirira, langirira tasirika.
Go on.
Genda maso.
Declare wealth.
Langirira bogaga.
Wealth.
Bogaga.
Wisdom.
Amagazi.
Wisdom.
Amagazi.
Wisdom.
Amagazi.
Even fame.
Na kutumo.
Even fame.
Na kutumo.
Upon your life.
Kumulamu bo.
Upon your life.
Kumulamu bo.
Upon your household.
Nyumba yo.
Upon your children.
Kumana bo.
Upon your husband.
Mami wo.
Upon your wife.
Kumuchale wo.
Upon your siblings.
Eriba genda bo.
Go on.
Genda maso.
Even upon this nation, Uganda.
Ya Uganda.
Declare it. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Decree it. You're breaking out. You are breaking out. You're breaking out. Out of poverty. You are breaking out. Out of witchcraft. Out of witchcraft. You are breaking out. Out of that curse. You are breaking out. Come on now. Declare. Declare. In the mighty name of Jesus. You are not little, you are not small.
Toli mutono, toli
you are
mutono.
Not little, you are not small.
Toli mutono.
You are not little, you are not small.
Toli mutono.
You are not little, you are not small.
Toli mutono.
You are a big nation.
Oli kwanga dene.
A big nation.
Oli kwanga dene.
A big nation.
Oli kwanga dene.
Greatness is yours.
Obukulu bubo.
Greatness is yours.
Obukulu bubo.
Greatness is yours.
Obukulu bubo.
Stretch. Stretch yourself. Break out.
Fire.
Break out.
Fire.
Break out.
Kuluma.
Come out.
Fire.
Come out.
Fire.
And go forth.
Erogane maso.
In the name of Jesus.
Mulinya lya Yesu.
In the name of Jesus.
Mulinya lya Yesu.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Mulinya lya Yesu lya manyi.
in the mighty name of Jesus. It's not by power, it's not by might, but it's by my spirit, says the Lord. It's by my spirit, says the Lord. In the name of Jesus. Amen. 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 Come on, let's go on. Let's give the Lord that clap offering. Give the Lord that clap offering. We are moving forward. We are coming out. We are coming out. Out of that dunghill. Out of that dunghill. We are coming out. The Lord is establishing us. He is establishing us. You won't die with that prophecy. You will not die with that prophecy. You will die with that dream. You will see it. You're gonna see it. But you need to break out. You need to break out. You need to stretch yourself by faith. Amen.
Amina.
Praise the Lord, church. Come on, let's thank Pastor Robert for the word. Praise the Lord. Kindly just take your seats so we do the announcements and a few other activities before we exit this place. But I just want to thank the Lord for this house. And I thank the Lord for each one of you. Let me see your hand if you're visiting us for the first time. We love it when we see you. Are you a guest in this house today? Just run us through our announcements for the month of July 2024. Right. These are the general in the sense that they occur regularly. We have daily prayers at the altar from 5 p.m. to 8 p.m. Monday to Friday. Right here at Kawempe Worship Center. And please, you are encouraged to attend. Come to the altar. Come to the altar, church. Amen.
Amina.
And then every Friday night, the youth gather here to pray. The youth, where are you? Hey, let me see you. Come on. Come on now. All right. Friday night, please come and pray. Come and get reignited. Come and get fired up in prayer. So you can stretch and get into your greatness. Stretch and break forth into your greatness. And then every Sunday, immediately after the second service, the youth again, you have a service. You're probably wondering, what is the big deal about the youth? Let me tell you, 80% of this population, even this Ugandan population.
Ne mu Uganda yonna okutwaliza awamu.
So you are the reason.
Ye mwe nno nsonga.
You are the movers.
Ye mwe abakyusa ebintu.
So we are blessing our eyes on you.
Amaso fena tugatunuliza
mwe. You are our hope, as
Ye
it were.
Ye mwe subiri ya fe.
Do not let us down.
Bambi temutuiwa.
Praise the Lord.
Mukama yebazibwe.
And every Sunday of the month.
Era buli Sunday semba yomu mwezi.
Every last Sunday of the month, thank
buli
you.
Buli Sunday semba yomu mwezi.
We have baptism and baby dedication.
Tuba no kubatiza no kuwayo abana.
And we request that if you have a plan of dedicating your baby or getting baptized,
era tukusaba obo inenteekateeka yokubatizibwa obo kuwayo mwana wo.
Kindly register ahead.
Nsaba we wandise ngo budde tebunatuuka.
Praise the Lord.
Amina.
And now these are specific announcements going to specific groups. For the men, on the 20th of July, you will have a breakfast meeting from 9 a.m. to 11
a.m.
Men, please show up. I had men only show up when you're talking about money. But I mean, it all starts with the word of God. So come to the men's meeting here at Kawempe Worship Center. You're
going
to get sharpened. Yes, you will be sharpened. And then for the young marrieds, on the 21st of July, you will have a meeting after the second service. Please approach Pastor Sam Kabunga for the details. Praise the Lord. Now, our revival week. Our revival week for this season, July 2024. It has been merged. We have merged it with the youth conference. The youth have a conference from the 26th to the
27th.
And it has been dubbed the Excavate Youth Conference. Excavate Youth Conference.
Youth conference say yabavubuka.
Invite somebody.
Bako goyaniriza.
And plan to attend. We have visitors from Canada. And they have a package for us. Please come.
Bambi jangu.
In large numbers.
Mubonji.
And then to the marrieds. The marrieds.
Abafumbo.
Marriage unveiled.
Abafumbo. Marriage unveiled.
Okay, our tea break is on the 28th of July.
Kachai kafe kaja kuba wonga bini munano mwezo gwa musanvu.
At 4 p.m.
Kusawa kumi.
At our usual place, Coping.
Mukafoka fakabuli joku Coping Hotel.
30,000 shillings per couple.
Mitwale satu uli mugogo gwa abafumbo.
Please attend.
Bambi jangu.
Attend for your own sake.
Jangu weyambe nga gwe.
Praise the Lord.
Amina.
All right, that brings us, okay, the last announcement.
Echirange chisembayo.
The leadership of inside, leadership, oh God, leadership insights and power lifters.
But leadership insights ne power lifters.
Yes, leadership insights and power lifters.
Leadership Insights class ne Power Lifters class.
Yes, that's a class on leadership.
Tubatuyigiriza bakulembeze.
They are recruiting.
Bali mukuwandisa bantu bapya kati.
They need resources.
Betaga ebyokozesa.
That's my understanding. They are recruiting. Please register with Pastor Raymond Magee.
Bad tandis okuwandisa abantu abokubangula we wandise ne Musumba Raymond Magee.
Okay, you'll get the details from Pastor Raymond or Mr. Tony Opio, the church administrator.
Okumanya bisinga wotu kirida Musumba Raymond oba Mr. Opio, administrator we kanisa.
Praise God.
Mukama yebazibwe.
That brings us to the end of our announcements today.
But why
am I forgetting this all the time? Young life, where are you?
But young life, muliwa.
Come on now. Come on, young life. I see just the young You know, I see the gentlemen, the girls, what has happened to you?
Young life.
Shoot up your hand. Okay, today is the second Sunday of the month. Right after this, we have an engagement. Kindly be there. Our subject is social etiquette. We are getting out of our comfort zone. And we are growing. God. Okay, we'll go to our next activity before we leave this place today. Kadoas, are you here?
Bakadoa,
is baby Jameni Florence here?
Omwana ono baby Jameni Florence.
I like the second name. Jameni Florence Isabella Kadoa.
Jameni Florence Isabella Kadoa.
I think you all know why she's called Florence.
Fernando Zatumanye Songaracho Mwano Mwalo Yatumidwa Florence.
I think she must have taken Mama Florence's name. Isn't that beautiful?
Banange
chosichirunji. That your grandchild takes your name while you're still living. Yeah, that is truly, truly,
Bananga truly.
We thank God for blessing them with the baby Jameni. So today we are dedicating her to the Lord. If I may ask, what does the name Jameni mean?
Singa mbuza amakulu gerinya lino elia Jameni makulu chi.
What does it mean?
Linye lyo litegeza chi.
Oh my goodness, God is all powerful.
Litegeza nti Katonda wa manyi nyo mu byonna.
Wow. What a great name.
Erinye lyo nga donji lya manyi.
All right. So I will ask our Pastor Robert to come and we dedicate the baby. The Bible says that children, they are a heritage from God.
Yes,
that the fruit of the womb is a reward. And that happy is the man whose hands are full of them.
Amen.
Can we all stand? The Bible says when Jesus was 8 days old.
Bible yagamba Yesu bwe
is because everyone must confess with their mouth that Jesus is Lord.
Kubanga buli muntu alina okweyatulira n'akamwa ke nga Yesu ye Mukama.
So we do this practice of dedicating babies, not baptizing them.
Kati ffe abaana tubawongeri Katonda wabula tetubabatiza.
But this is a beautiful baby.
Ono mwana nga mulungi nnyo.
And we dedicate Jamima. What's that? Jameni. That's a family name. I've been told that's a family name.
Bangambe yerinya lya family Jameni.
Why are you sad when
what's we so dedicating this baby?
Can you stretch out your hands and let's bless this baby? Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you for the gift of a baby. Me in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. To be a baby that's going to grow up in the presence of the Lord. Just like Samuel the prophet did.
yawulira eddoboozi lya
katondan'ayiga
amakubo ga
katondan'abeera
nga mu kubeerawo kwa
mukamajame
ne tumuwongakulire nga mu kubeerawo kwa mukama
abeere
omwana ajjudde omukisa n'okuganja
n'ekitiibwa
kya katonda kyakeeyakenga ku
ye
tusaba tewaabe endwadde tewaabe butyabaga tewaabe bubi
bunaatuuka
ku ye mu linnya lya
yesu
tulangirira omusaayi gwa yesu ku
mwana ono
tumuwa omukisa
gw'okuganja
amagezi agava waggulu
tukwebaza
n'olw'abazadde mukama
Entrance of Jamemi be the beginning.
Leko kucha kwa Jamemi kubentandikwa.
Of a blessing uncountable.
Eyo mukisa ogutabalirwa.
May you bless this house, the Kadowa family.
Enyumba ya Kadowa juwo mukisa.
May you increase and expand them.
Obongereko eroba gaziye.
May you provide for them to raise this baby in the presence of God.
Bagabirira kuso mwana ono mukubera kwa mukama.
We pray that they will not lack anything good.
Tusaba tababulwenga chintu chirunji.
But have more than enough.
Neba bere nebisukuse kubimala.
We bless this family.
Famireno tujiwo mukisa.
And the extended family.
Era ne famire yonna kutwaliza wamo.
In Jesus name.
Mulinya lya Yesu.
In Jesus name.
Mulinya lya Yesu.
Amen.
Amina. Kama yebazibwe.
We congratulate you, the Kadowas.
Bakadowa tubayoza yoza.
And yes. Please do receive the card.
Ne card yi no.
So you will show her.
Munachi
she's able to read.
Nga sobola okusoma.
Thanksgiving. Yes, we'll receive it. They have brought Thanksgiving.
Bale
Jamemi Florence.
Echokwebaza.
Isabella.
Echa Jamemi Florence Isabella Kadowa.
Yes. Once again we congratulate you the Kadowas.
Nateba Kadowa tubayoza yoza mukuliko omwana.
Amen. Yes.
Amina.
Yes. Praise God.
Mukama yebazibwe.
Let's have the baskets we need to give.
Katufune ebibotu weyo mu nyumba ya mukama.
Yes. The Bible says.
Bible egamba.
It is more blessed to give.
Mukisa okugaba.
Than to receive.
Okusinga okuwebwa.
And the same Bible says.
Era Bible egamba.
That what you sow.
Tigwe bulichono siga.
Is what you reap.
Nawe chono okungula.
If you sow two seeds.
Bosige nsigo biri.
You reap one cup.
Nawe okungula chikopo chimo.
If you sow a bucket of seeds.
Bono sige nsige nyinje nyo.
You reap a sack.
Nawe chakungula nsawo.
Praise God.
Mukama yebazibwe.
Now that second part is mine.
Echecho kubirinza chigaseko.
But that's what the scripture says.
Ne Bible yegamba anti.
Yeah, if you sow sparingly.
Bo siganga ukekereza.
Indeed you will reap sparingly.
Mazima ukungulo ukekereza.
And the opposite is also true.
Echecho kontana necho chitufu.
And the Bible also says.
Era Bible yegamba.
That blessed is the generous soul.
Ntie meme gabagaba ya mukisa.
The generous soul.
Ememe gabagaba.
It will be rich.
Eneka gawala.
And that he who waters.
Ero yafukirira.
Shall also be watered himself.
Atakufukirirwa.
So I'm encouraging you this afternoon. To make this an issue.
Eno jifule nsonga.
Make it a habit.
Jifule muzee.
Make it a habit.
Jifule muzee.
To bring into the house of the Lord.
Okuletanga mu nyumba ya mukama.
Because indeed it is blessed to give.
Kubanga mazima mukisa gwo kugaba.
It is more blessed to give.
Cha mukisa nyo.
Amen.
Amina.
We shall pray and then you'll bring.
Tukenda kusaba orolete.
Father, we thank you once again.
Tata tukwebazana te.
As your children bring into your house.
Gabana babaleta munju yo.
They bring their offerings, they bring their tithes, they bring the seed.
Balete biwebwayo ebimwe bya 10 n'sigo.
Many are bringing from the little that they have.
Banji baleto kuva ko bitono bya balina.
But God, may you fulfill your word.
Naye mukama nsaba otukirize kigambo
kyo. May you surprise us, Lord.
Nsaba otwewunyise mukama.
May you surprise us. May you enlarge us, Lord.
Twewunyise nga botugaziya.
May you increase us, Lord.
Nsaba otongereko mukama.
And as we bring with joy.
Era nga botuleta mu ssanyu.
As we bring with happiness.
Nga botuleta n'okusanyuka.
Father, we pray.
Tata nsaba.
That you'll give us a harvest.
Otuwa makungula.
As we bring some, as some of us bring in tears.
Nga bamutuleta tukaba.
May we come back with joy as we come to testify of your greatness. May you meet our needs, oh God, that none of us will lack anything good. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Amen. Okay, church, come on, just go ahead and bring. Bless, if you have a tithe, you know the basket with the tithe, your offering, and then if you are online, we have online platforms. We have the Airtel and MTN merchant codes. We have the bank account at Equity Bank. If you want to give your offering, your seed, your tithe. And then we have a mobile money number in the names of Pastor Robert Kasozi. And then finally, we have an ABSA account. If you are giving for the church construction. Praise the Lord. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. The youth, where are you? You have your skit, come. Just bring your skit. Let's welcome them. Come on, church. Let's welcome the youth. Let's see the energy, come on. I need some energy.
Excuse me, DJ, what's CJ? A moment. Yeah, these things. Are you seeing this? Hallelujah! Raise them in the air. Let them, show them this. Brothers and sisters, this is what is going to happen soon. Hallelujah!
Amen.
Somebody is having them behind there. Can you raise? Oh my God, I think we need to give them some they go back with home, eh? Yeah, let them know out there that we are preparing something massive. Hallelujah! Let's dance together, hallelujah.
Yeah.
Show me some dance. Hallelujah! This kind love, for sure, I need to make a nice place for you. In my hard times, stay with joy. Vibe, everyone, see this kind loving for sure. Giving your life for me. It got my eyes on Calvary. I feel better with you, oh Lord. And if I got your glory, all is for my good. I'm so contented with you, oh Lord. And if I'm in your glory, all is for my good. Let's go. To you I give every minute of praise. With you every minute has a meaning. With you my life has a meaning. Somebody shout for Jesus! Hallelujah!
What?
Some of my people than us. Let's go. Let's go. Show us.
Mama!
DJ! This love you can buy. No one can buy it. You can buy. Let's go. Let's go.
Who is it? What is it?
This love
you can buy.
You can buy. See my blessings come from.
What did he say?
You want to give every minute of praise with you. Every minute has a meaning.
Thank you very much.
DJ.
Thank you, young people. Come on, church.
Hello, church.
Amen.
Mwe. Chinana. Ene kanisa judeva vubuka.
This church is full.
So, tatuiza ba chintu ku level ngo cha
tudengo. We can't be this level when you're
DJ soko be.
You mean it.
Son of. You mean it.
We have an excavator.
Lava yongabili mukaga. Paka ngabili mukaga.
All of us here.
On Friday, we are beginning at exactly 5.
Tutandika sawa kuminemu.
Paka sawa nyeze chilo.
Up to 10.
Orom kaga.
On Saturday.
Tutandika sawa sate zo kumacha.
We start at 9.
Paka kuminemu.
Up to sawa kuminemu.
Wa iwe mere.
There is a four. Do
I will be there.
We are going to have a praise what?
Fena magumba gacha alimapia.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
DJ tu vewa.
DJ give us.
Alright.
When we say.
Okay. That was for Escavet Youth Conference. Sorry, I had to cut them short. Planning to be a disciplined space here. We are growing into our greatness. And timekeeping is one of those things. We promise you that you'd leave this place by 1. And that's what we want to make sure we do all the time. Please stand up so I release a blessing and we leave this place. Praise the Lord. May the Lord bless you. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord cause you to be above and not beneath. The Lord cause you to be the head and not the tail. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord defend you and keep you. May He protect you. May He provide for you. The Lord cause you to be at peace with your enemies. Yes, the Lord bless you, church. And may He be your peace. May He be your peace. And when you return, may you bring a testimony. And say, see what the Lord has done. In Jesus' mighty name. And everybody said amen. 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 Amina.
Praise the Lord. And may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all now and forevermore. Amen. Amen. We love you, church. We'll see you during the week. Please make it a point to greet somebody as you leave this place. Don't just run away. Meet somebody. And the Lord will bless you. We love you.